which is an extremely exciting project, Women, Voice and Leadership.
This project is part of a broader series of funding that we committed to developing women's leadership around the world. So we will be putting projects like this together in 30 countries for a total of $150 million. So that's about 1.2 million rand. Sorry, 1.2 billion. Yeah. It's really to help organizations be even stronger than what they're already doing. So things like strengthening even further performance, sustainability, have the programming and advocacy that you're undertaking be even more efficient, impactful, significant in advancing women's equality and empowering women and girls throughout the country. This will be working not only at a national level, but also subnational provinces and other as you represent, to make sure that women's rights platforms, networks, and alliances are as effective as they can be at changing policy, legal frameworks, and the expectations of society and culture in South Africa.
It's amazing how many voices we have. You know, when you're a woman, sometimes in the spaces where people do not understand gender and do not understand feminism, whenever you try and put out there the things that you go through as a woman, they put it aside. And it's important that we have a strong voice. It's important that we have power. And one of the things that provide power to anybody in the world is money. So I appreciate this. I feel honored to be standing here in front of you, mainly because my voice can be heard. And I'm happy that we've got men that are sitting here with us. Maybe we can give them a clap. I'm not the typical South African young woman that you would find. I'm not part of the masses, I'm not part of the bulk of South African young women who are located in rural areas, that do not have access to opportunities, that do not have a voice, that cannot be heard by their chiefs, the traditional chiefs and leaders who are within their communities and also in government.
No, the line is so thin. You've got to hold the line. This thing called democracy is fragile. We have it today, it can go tomorrow. We don't need to look far in our region to see how democracy comes. Very quickly. Let's hold on to it. Gender equality, these gains we've made in 25 years, they can come and go very quickly. We have to keep holding the line, pushing the line, and for that, we need to move together with the young women.
Womanga! The last time we came feast, the walls lost our screams into a song, and the neighbors danced to a shout of men. This house will watch us get killed and say nothing. The walls wear our blood like paint. Our DNA washes off into color. It is a battle when one boxing champion gets to the fight, constantly waging through kitchen towers. We slowly rise to our knees, talent and prayer, with the ceiling, slipping our ways back into our hearts, as if to say that what we are asking is a distant kind of heaven that we will never reach, where men don't molest women, where houses are not most wanted, where fathers love